Hey guys, so today we're going to be taking a look at the commuter backpack from the Ridge. And you may be familiar with the company's original flagship product, which is the Ridge Wallet, that has a very durable and minimalistic design that's been very popular across multiple EDC blogs. And I haven't had a chance to test that out, but I've heard very good things about the wallet. So I was very excited when the company reached out to see if I wanted to test out one of their new backpacks. And so I've been using this for the past couple of weeks, and so far it's been a really good experience. The bag doesn't try to reinvent the wheel, but it's just a very solid EDC offering with a nice build quality, and it's very comfortable to wear. So I want to go ahead and thank the company for sending the bag for me to test out, and I'm really excited to share it with you guys. So let's just jump in and take a closer look at the commuter backpack from the Ridge. So starting out with the outside of the bag, the commuter backpack has a very modern and techy feel. It reminds me a lot of bags that we've seen from companies like Incase and Air. So just a nice overall look, definitely gonna fit in well while taking to the office or for walking around the city. On the outside, the bag is made out of a water-resistant nylon shell. It also has well-protected zippers all throughout. I particularly like these zippers on the main compartment. They have some really solid water sealing to help keep water away from your electronics. I'm not sure if the zippers are YKK. I haven't been able to find any sort of labeling on the inside, but they have worked very well and they feel like they're gonna hold up. As far as the capacity, the bag is actually offered in two sizes. The one that we have here is the smaller 14 liter version, which is meant to hold up to a 15 inch laptop. If you need a little bit more space, the bag is also offered in a 20 liter version that's supposed to handle up to a 17 inch laptop. So nice to have that variety of sizes. As far as the smaller size that we have here, this has worked very well for most of the items that I typically need on my day-to-day. It has a very slim silhouette, so it's not gonna be great for holding bulkier items, but it does hug your bag very closely, so if you don't carry as much with you throughout the day and you just want something slim that's gonna be very easy to maneuver in crowded areas, the smaller silhouette is gonna work very well. For my size and frame, I did feel that the 14 liter version of the bag was a little bit tight and smaller than what I would typically like to wear. So if you're over 5'11" or 6 feet, I may recommend checking out the 20 liter version of the bag as it might be a little bit more comfortable. Continuing along the outside, the bag has water bottle compartments on each side. They offer a nice amount of space. Currently what I have in here is the same water bottle that you've seen in all my other daily bag videos. So that comes out very easily. And although the compartments offer a nice amount of elasticity, I don't think you could fit anything much thicker than the water bottle that I currently had in there. So if you have a thicker Nalgene, that's gonna be a little bit of a tighter fit. One nice feature that these side pockets have is this zipper that allows you to close them up when they're not in use to help the bag keep a cleaner look. Another nice feature on the outside of the bag is this external USB port that you can use to connect to a portable battery on the inside of the bag so that you can charge your phone while you're on the go. At the top, the bag has a very comfortable and well-padded handle so that you can carry the bag around if you don't want to wear it. This has a nice meshy material on the inside, and it's nice how it hugs the bag pretty closely so that it doesn't stick up awkwardly. Before moving on to the straps and the back paneling, here at the bottom I have attached my Hero Clip carabiner that I use to keep the bag elevated off the ground. This combines nicely with this little loop that the bag has at the top so that you don't have to hang anything by the nicer handle. As far as the straps, they have been very comfortable to wear. They have a nice amount of padding, nice and thick. On the inside, they have a meshy material to help prevent moisture from building up. The width of the straps was fine considering the smaller size of the bag, but they were a little bit smaller than what I would typically like to use for my day-to-day. The straps also have an adjustable sternum strap that you can use to help distribute the weight, which I'm not sure how necessary this is for the smaller size of the bag, but still nice to have. Moving on to the back paneling, I really like how this was implemented here. Nice, comfortable padding all around. It has a nice meshy material to prevent moisture from building up. And I like the amount of elevation on all the padding to create this air channel here to help airflow throughout the day. On the back, there's also a nice luggage passer so that if you're traveling with an additional carry-on bag, you can just rest this on the handle so that you don't have to wear the bag while you're walking around the airport. The last thing I'll mention while we're on the back is the secret compartment near the bottom that offers an RFID protected area to store some of your more valuable items. So currently what I have in here is just my Field Notes notebook, but this would be a great spot to put something like your wallet or your passport to help keep them protected while you're walking around. Jumping into the organizational options of the bag, on the front there's just two very simple quick access compartments so that you can get to your smaller accessories throughout the day. I like how the zippers of these compartments are kind of hidden to make them a little bit better protected against pickpockets, so you kind of have to dig in here to get to the zipper pull, but they open up easily and they offer a nice amount of space. Currently what I have in here is my Ray-Bans with their case, and then I also have a lightning cable to charge my phone, and then the last item that I have in here is just my GoPro Hero 3 Plus. So really like how much this compartment comes out to be able to handle some of those bulkier items. It's also pretty tall at the top. You have a little bit of extra space here. So just a nice simple compartment, no sort of internal organization or felt lining on the inside. At the bottom, there is another quick access compartment. This one's a little bit smaller than the one we just looked at, but similar style. No internal organization or felt lining in this compartment either. So another simple area to just throw in something a little bit slimmer. Currently what I have in here is just my Kindle. And then the only other item that I have in here is my Gerber Dime multi-tool. And one thing that I noticed about this compartment is that even though it still comes out a nice amount, it does share a little bit more space with some of the items that float to the bottom of your bag. So some of the bulkier items that we'll see in a second take up the volume here. So I wasn't able to fit something quite as thick as I did in the top area. So my GoPro or my sunglasses, they would still probably be able to squeeze in there, but it would be kind of a tight fit. Next up, there is a larger organizational compartment with a nice well-protected zipper. And this has a wider opening so that you can see the items on the inside. There is a little bit of internal organization in this pocket here, but the first thing I'll mention is that it does go all the way down to the bottom of the bag, so it does share some volume with these compartments here. And so towards the bottom, what I currently have is my GoRuck wired up, which is where I keep most of my smaller dongles and tech accessories. And then towards the top, there's just a few simple slip pockets for your accessories. Here in this first one, what I have is my UTech wireless charger for my phone. And this is a little bit larger. I like how much space is provided here. It's elevated off the bottom. It goes about the length of my fingers. And then next to that, there's a few small slots for something like a pen or stylus. Currently what I have in here is just my stylus laser pointer combo. And then next to those, there is another simple slip pocket that's a little bit smaller than the first one that we looked at. It's about half the size. So this is gonna be a great spot for something smaller like a mouse or maybe even your phone if you don't wanna carry it in your pocket throughout the day. So really nice job with this compartment here. I like the amount of space that was offered all throughout and that the company kept the organization to a minimum and didn't go crazy adding too many slip pockets. The last compartment we're gonna be taking a look at is the main area that also houses the laptop compartment. A nice thing about this compartment is that the zippers are actually lockable if you wanna keep your laptop a little bit better protected. And so this is a top loading bag, but the zippers do come down nice enough to be able to see into the compartment. And although this is primarily for the laptop, it's nice that there's plenty of extra space in this compartment for some of your flatter and taller accessories. So the first thing that you see here is my Levitate portable standing desk. Then I also have a simple folder for my receipts and papers. And then I also have my full-size Moleskine notebook. And now with the compartment empty, you can get a feel for how much space it offers. The bag itself is very slim, so there's not a lot of extra capacity here. This is definitely not a bag that's gonna be great for holding something like your gym clothes or a larger lunchbox. And so on the front of this compartment, there's two additional slip pockets that you can use for something like your power bank. Here you see the USB cable that connects to the port on the outside. So I currently have that attached to my BluePop portable Bluetooth speaker and power bank here. And this compartment has a nice amount of space and depth. So if you have one of those larger anchor power banks, it's gonna be able to fit in there comfortably. And then next to that, you have a smaller slip pocket here that you could use to hold something like a portable hard drive or a mouse. Currently what I have in here is my Apple Magic Mouse. And then the last thing I wanna talk about is the shockproof laptop compartment. So really like how this compartment was implemented here. Nice Velcro strap, making sure to keep the laptop in place. And so this bag is meant to hold up to a 15-inch laptop. As you can see, I have my 13-inch MacBook Pro in here, but there's a little bit of leftover space. The larger version of the bag would be good for holding a 17-inch laptop. So if you have a bigger device, that'll be something to definitely keep in mind. And then a really nice thing about this laptop compartment is that you can actually adjust the fit so that it better fits your device. On the side, you have these Velcro flaps that you can use to make them come in a little bit closer if you have a smaller device, or if you have a bigger or thicker device, you're also gonna have a little bit more flexibility with how you can adjust that. So really like having that option. The padding itself is nice and thick. It definitely feels like it's gonna keep your laptop well protected. It's not elevated off the bottom of the ground, but there is a nice amount of padding at the bottom so you still feel like your device is protected if you place the bag on the ground. And then it's very easy to just pull the laptop out. It comes out smoothly. And now you can get a better look at this padding on the back. I really like this soft foam that they've added here. I can definitely see why they call this a shockproof compartment. Between the rigid paneling on the front and this soft foamy material here, it definitely feels like your device is gonna be very well protected throughout the day. So a really great job with how the laptop compartment was implemented here and with the overall layout of the bag. I really like the minimal yet effective organizational options that it offered, its clean style. And if you're looking for a durable and versatile bag that's gonna come in at under $100, it's gonna be a good option to check out. And so to wrap up, I really enjoyed testing out the commuter backpack over the past couple of weeks. It has a nice, clean, minimalistic look. It's comfortable to wear. It has a solid build quality and it comes in at a pretty good price. And so you can purchase this on Amazon or the Ridge's site for about $85. And I think this is a pretty reasonable price considering the build quality and features that the bag has to offer. It's a little bit more solidly built than some of the more budget options that we featured on the channel. And it compares well against other bags in this similar price range and style. The first bag this reminded me of was the In-Case Compass Backpack, which is another minimal daily bag that has a lot of nice organizational options, some good laptop protection. It's not quite as well built as this one, but it has a little bit of a different style. So if you like the In-Case brand and you're just looking for a versatile daily carry from them, the Compass Backpack is gonna be a good option to check out. The next bag this reminded me of was the OnePlus Travel Backpack. Both bags had a very similar slim silhouette. This one had a little bit more in the area of organization, but it didn't handle bulkier items quite as well as the OnePlus Travel Backpack. They both come in a very close $75 to $85 price range. I feel like this one's a little bit better built, but if you're looking for something that's gonna be able to handle bulkier items better and has a similar feel, I definitely recommend checking out the OnePlus Travel Backpack as well. Another good option to check out would be something like the Timbuktu Q Backpack, which is very well built. It has a similar slim silhouette with lots of nice organizational options for your tech. And of course, with the Timbuktu brand, you know you're gonna get something that's gonna hold up well over the longer term. That bag also comes in at under $100, so it's gonna be a good alternative to check out if you want something with a little bit of a different style. Another good option to check out if you have a little bit of a higher budget would be something like the Air Day Pack, which has a very clean, minimalistic style. It's gonna work very well for something like an office environment. It has some great organizational options, and I feel like the build quality is gonna be a little bit better on that one. It comes in at around $125, but it's a really solid bag, and if you want something that's gonna be a little bit more stylish, that might be a good option to check out. The last option I'll mention here, if you have a little bit of a tighter budget, a good option to check out would be something like the Inatech Business Laptop Backpack, which we looked at a few weeks ago. That has a very similar style to this bag. It doesn't have quite the same build quality and it's a little bit bigger, but it comes in at closer to $40. So if you're looking to save a little bit of money and you like the style of this bag, that'll be a great option to check out as well. With that being said, the commuter backpack holds up really well to those bags. And if you're looking for a solid, stylish daily carry bag that's gonna come in at under $100, I definitely recommend you guys check this one out. And so I wanna go ahead and thank the company again for sending the bag for me to test out. And if you guys found this video helpful, please go ahead and give us a like. And if you haven't already, please go ahead and subscribe so you don't miss any upcoming videos. And thank you guys so much.